Good evening, good evening, welcome. My name is Obinako. I want to share with you briefly what I call expectations, realities, and pivots. Expectations, realities, and pivots. It's one thing to start a business and have that or those kind of you know, high ambitions and dreams and having a straight path to you realizing your goals. And it's a whole another thing for you to really go through the practicalities in the rare situations on the ground to get to the dreams. And this is what most often shakes a lot of people. A lot of people give up because the realities usually are different. You know, so you have an expectation of you know, you before you start the business, you have an expectation. Let's say you want to start a maybe water processing, water bottling business. And so you sit down, especially people who have done some kind of work before, who have professional experiences, professional exposure. They are able to write all the cost component of the business. They are able to prepare very good business plan. You know, they are very sure of the path because to most of them, the path is straight. So they know that, okay, I need 5,000 to start this business. And looking at my projections, I will be able to sell maybe 1,000 pieces, you know, 1,000 units of the water. And at the end of the month, I'll be able to make 20,000. So when I take my 5,000 from it, I have 15,000 profit. They do the mathematics well. Everything is perfect. You know, those are the expectations of the business, of the dream. Now you hit the ground and then you just saw that the cost, the 5,000 that you assumed that will be enough, actually it was not 5,000. And that the person that you gave the money to even go and do the bottles for you run away with the money. or the time that you thought that you could start the business, maybe you credited the money, the time that you thought that the business could start, you delayed for another 2 months. And so the interest was running on the money. All kind of things. Or you have people that you thought you could depend on, and when everything became rough, they run away from you. All these things are realities. And sometimes people go through this kind of situations in their quest to build a business for a very long time. And so your original idea, usually, most often than not, if it's your first business, it's not going to be the usually. It's not going to be the, you know, the very thing that will make you become successful as a business. And that is the pivot or the pivot point, okay? Because you have an idea, you just start a business. You have a specific product, you have your design, everything. And then you have your expectation, and you think that things will go as you expect. But then when you hit the ground, you start to gather information. You start to see that what you had in mind was not as accurate as what you experienced on the field. And that is what usually deters a lot of people. It makes a lot of people give up. A lot of people become impatient. A lot of people would have it in their mind that, but I didn't expect all these kind of difficulties and problems and challenges. And when it hits like that, many of them give up on their dream. Many of them give up on their dream to own the business because they think that is unique with them. There is something we call pivot point. Okay, those are the points that you probably started the water bottle business and you had a design in your mind, and then you hit the ground and you saw that maybe the competition was tough. Maybe you decided to do it in Kumasi or in Sunyani or maybe in Takoradi. But once you started to, you know, you saw that the thing was not moving as, so you started to move to people, talk to people, negotiate with people. Sometimes you may even shut the plant down. Then out of your meetings with somebody will just chip in an idea, say, ah, I was thinking of a product and I thought that there's a whole demand for it. And then maybe you come up with a new idea out of the fact that you wanted to start one. Now it becomes a food processing, you know, a fruit processing company out of that. So usually the ideas that most companies start with, most business people, most entrepreneurs, the ideas that they start with, usually the product, the services that they start with, most of them, they don't become the original ideas that they succeed in. But what separates them from the others who give up is that the expectations, and between the expectations and the realities, you have a lot of pivot points. The pivots are the ones that the light that jumps up to illuminate something in you, to give you a leverage, to give you an idea, that to give you a business, to give you something that you hardly ever expected. But because you started to do something, because you started the business, because you started the product, because you kept on doing that, those pivot points jump. And usually those are the points that bring the change the game, the game changes. And so you started to sell all these products and you saw that in the market, if you had to add something to that, maybe you'll be able to increase the sales of the business, or maybe you'll be able to succeed. Or maybe you started as a construction company, brick and mortar. And then once you are doing it, out of nowhere, somebody gave you a project, and that was probably in the mining sector. And then you went there and you saw a whole different businesses, and you probably reduced the construction. And before you see it, you have a mining company. But if you had not started the construction company, that pivot would not have happened. And so when people start businesses, or when they are journeying to realizing their dreams, what they overlook is that there will be a pivot point. There will be a moment that will be pivotal, and that will change the story of your business. That will change. You probably will just started to say that what are the businesses that people? I want to sell provisions, you know, and you're selling the provisions, and maybe you got into troubles. You got a lot of losses, and in you talking, there's something from nowhere comes up, and the next minute you see you have, you know, another business that was entirely different from the original provision business that you started, you know. So there are expectations that we all have, and usually the expectations are way, way, way different from the realities on the ground. But you must have the expectations, because without the expectations, you will not even start. And there's a level of naivety in the expectations, but it's still okay to have your expectations. Have them big, but also be open that once you hit the ground, the realities will teach you a lot of lessons, and the realities will bring all your inefficiencies and all the strength that you think you have. The things that you are so much confident in, some of them will crumble, some of them will fail, some of them will drop, and you may not even be able to gather them back. Right, but the process is that once you have the expectations and the realities become different, you don't have to stop there. You still have to keep going, because you are looking for the pivot moment. The pivots, and they come up like that. Sometimes you are just there and they hit you. Sometimes you just see a situation and they hit you. Sometimes somebody is talking and that hits you. Sometimes you are nowhere and somebody calls you out of nowhere to say that this is it, and they happen. Most often at the distress point, at the point that you are virtually giving up, and you see that something from nowhere, it's like, ah, didn't I come and join you? Then out of nowhere, somebody just calls you to say that, I have this business for you, come, let's talk. You know, and so they may not even be part of the things that you originally thought, usually. But because you started to go, because you kept on going, and these are unique with entrepreneurship, with startups, and sometimes even with running businesses, where you get into situations where something out of nowhere just pops up, and that thing becomes that which will change the business, which will change your revenue, which will compensate for all the pain, the struggles, the losses, the difficulties that you have endured all this while. And so when you start a business and somebody does not believe in you, don't worry about it, because no matter what you do, you are going to meet a lot of those antagonism, and they are coming from the kind of education that you had. They're coming from the school, they're coming from the religiosities. You know, the culture is even opposite to you. Most people who want to live their destiny will meet all kind of oppositions. Okay, they meet the oppositions from the family, from the education, because usually if you have education, but even African especially, by the time that you finish having the so-called education, you know, when the African is not going to school, you want to send them to school. By the time that they finish this kind of education that they have given us, all your confidence will have been gone, all your aspirations, all your passion will have been gone. You will be trained to only look for job, and with that job, you feel like you're useless because of the kind of information that they have given us. Now, this becomes a challenge to you trying to do something which is opposite the kind of education that they have given you. You know, so the strength of most people usually is gone in trying to dare, because the education they gave us continuously fights against our dream. You know, our dream fights against our dream. They fight against the expectations that we have. They fight against, and when you get on the field, the realities will support the education, what they told you. That they told you that it is very difficult, it's tough, you can make it, you just have to follow the script that everybody else is following. This kind of challenges will also come from the culture. Most people, if you follow the culture, you will never build anything which is original. You will never do anything which is phenomenal, which is monumental. You will never, because the culture does not expect much from you. Okay, because it's a script. Why do you want to go against what we all know? What do you want? What makes you think that you're special, you're different? And yet, if you want to do anything significant, virtually, not morally, but in terms of thinking, in terms of aspirations, you virtually have to go against what the culture continuously pushes on us. You know, and the other thing is the religious beliefs, okay? Because the kind of religion that they have told us is that you have to wait for God, you have to wait for somebody to give you power, you have to wait for some prophet somewhere, you have to wait for a pastor to declare some words on you. Those may work for a while, but that which gives consistent results, that which gives consistent results, is the sharpness of your mind, the clarity of your thinking, the principles that you understand, that you follow. Those are the people who are succeeding in this life. Those are the things that you have learned. Those are the things that they practice. So your conviction, now you want to get into that business, that reality, that expectation of you owning a business. They forget that there are pivots. Okay, so it's not going just going to be down. So they are not just valleys. There will be ups. There will be ups, and the up moment, just one up moment, can change the whole situation for you. But the Bible information that they have given us, especially the Christians, okay, they have conditioned us to not to only not to you know look into ourselves to see the kind of strength, the kind of expertise that we have to build, the ethics that we need to build anything out of nothing. And so most people, all their lives, they are waiting for one word from God, one word from a man of God, one word from a prophet. And people have been conditioned to wait for that, and they wait for that all their lives, and they become nothing. Why? Because that which produces consistent results, they come from that which you have practiced. Practice the principles, the quality of principles, the quality of ideas that you have practiced. The things that the skill that you have developed, those are the ones that are producing the results that you have. Whether you believe it or not, the kind of life that you're enjoying today, whether it's family, whether it's business, whatever, whether it's health, everything, they are direct reflection of the kind of understanding, the kind of wisdom, the kind of principles, the kind of qualities that you have developed all your life. Okay, because I think that that is really where the power is. The power is in the principles that can continuously produce the results that you want without waiting for a magic. Okay, so there are expectations, there are realities, and there are pivots. What most people only understand is that they just wait for all the bad moments. It never occurs to them that if I continue to go, if I continue to progress, if I continue to try this, there will be that moment that I will find something. And so the secret is in the doing. The secret is really in the doing. So when you start a business or when you're doing business and everybody's talking you down, keep going. Keep going. Because in the doing, you start to discover a lot of revelations. In the doing, you become wiser. In the doing, you become skilled. In the doing, you start to build a big network. In the doing, you start to see results. And once you start to get results, you see that things continue to improve at the least moment. And so my name is Obendako. I shared with you expectations, realities, and the people. Never give up. Never give up when the expectations are not in the reality, because they will never be in the reality. Expectations are always different from the reality. Okay, it's never going to be where all your expectations, the realities will be there, but don't give up. Continue on to go. There will be a light moment, and that is the pivot. Almost all the businessmen that you hear about, the great ones, those who have practiced ethics, people who have achieved anything in any field, that will start pivotal moment. And that moment is what changed the trajectory of their career, of their business, of everything that they were doing. Okay, so when it is part of the process for you to start and go through a lot of difficult moments, because the dream, the expectations, was the point, was the loop up that you needed. Because if you started with a reality, then you wouldn't have started at all. Because the reality is really full of the reality is really full of all the challenges. Sorry, if you were that intelligent, if you were that smart, and you saw all the reality, wouldn't have started in the first place. You would never start if you had the realities, because the realities are the things that you see, this the difficulties. And that's why the child can work. Child has an ambition. The child starts to walk. You see, they are very